Hunter x Hunter episodes 57 and 58. So they go back to the hotel with Killua and Korn. And for some reason, Leo Rio is in the lobby. And he's being loud and annoying and pretending like he doesn't know who these people are that he's looking at. So it's all very sneaky what they've planned here. It's pretty awesome, actually. And so as soon as the lights go out, because that's what the plan is, Killua is going to escape from the thread that got them all tied up, and then they'll escape. So Pakunoto and her group shows up, and Krollo tells her to read Killua and Gon's minds. So the way her ability works is that she asks a question in order to stimulate a piece of their brain that will remember a certain thing so she can tell whether they're lying. So it's all pure, unaltered memories. So they can't just think about something else. But thankfully, that's exactly when the lights go out. Oh, Killua escapes from his threats. And Gon attacks, and they, like, break her arm. It was awesome. I can't handle this. Killua escapes, but he still has to rescue Gon. And when he goes back to rescue Gon, Machi grabs onto him so he can't escape. So it's, like, so much for that escape plan. They've been recaptured. But for some reason, we just noticed that the boss is missing. So, okay, something weird has just happened. There was a message thrown in, and so the boss is missing. And the message says that if you talk about the memories that you just learned from Gon and Killua, then I will kill him. Implying that that whoever sent this message has taken Krollo, the boss, and is going to kill him. But Pakunoda goes through her mind and she's like, well, from what I know about the chain user is that he must be very, very intelligent and very good at what he does, so therefore I believe he is not bluffing. So the other members of the Phantom Troop are like, don't say anything, let's just get through this, let's figure this out without any additional information. Pakunoda is thinking about how the boss told them one time that the priority is to keep the spider alive, not to keep an individual alive. He's the head right now, but if he dies, then one of the legs can become the head. And so that they should keep that in mind. So she's kind of like, And then she remembers the fortune that she got. Would it be a betrayal to speak? Oh my god! So Krollo and Kurapika and Melody and Leo Rio are all in a car. And Krollo's all tied up with the chains. And Krollo's like, I really don't even care about what's happening right now. It wasn't even in my fortune, so clearly it wasn't important enough to mention. Melody points out that Krollo's not lying when he says that he is not valuable as a hostage, because he told the Phantom Troop that if he was ever captured, then they should just, like, you know, it's not about the individual, like I talked about before. Krollo is trying really hard to provoke Kurapika into doing something stupid. But instead, Kurapika calls up the Phantom Troop and he's like, I have three demands. One, don't follow me. Two, don't hurt your hostages. Three, let me talk to Pakunoda. Kurapika explains how she's forbidden from talking about what she learned. She can't talk to them, she can't gesture, she can't do anything. She can't do anything to indicate what she knows. And now he's gonna meet with Pakunoda alone, and no one else is allowed to come. In fact, the Phantom Troop has all decided to follow her. And then they're like, but you know, we'll play it by ear. But Nobunaga strongly feels like they shouldn't follow her. Oh my goodness gracious, and then, like, Hisoka is making plans to fight the boss now, and he sends a message to Illumi. He's got plans, evil plans. I find it really hard to believe that in one episode this arc is gonna be over. It's just crazy to me that we could be going to a new arc in only 23 minutes. So let's watch episode 58. So when the episode starts, Pakunoda is meeting up with Kurapika, who's got Melody with him, along with Krollo wrapped up in chains. And Krollo knows that Kurapika is more concerned with rescuing Gon and Killua than he is with killing him. So he's hoping that Pakunoda is keen to that knowledge and has brought along the rest of the Phantom Troop. So Kurapika sends his chain into Krollo's body and wraps around his heart. And then he sends a chain into Pakunoda's heart under the conditions that if she talks about Kurapika at all, then Krollo will die. And if she doesn't release Killua and Gon by midnight, then Krollo will die. And I think she will die too. Melody is thinking about how even though Krolla believes that the Phantom Troop is not out to save him. He, like, honestly believes that. Melody is assessing Pakunoda, and she's kind of feeling like, I don't think that this woman feels the same way. I think she really legitimately wants to save her boss. Pakunoda goes back to the group, and she's like, guys, this is the situation. And they're all kind of like, about that situation. We don't know how we feel about that. So half the troop wants to follow, but then half the troop is like, no. So they're gonna fight each other, maybe. Woo! And then Gon gets pissed and breaks out of his chains and starts yelling. And Killua's just sitting there like, whoa, bro. I mean, you know, yeah, he does it too. He breaks out of his chains too. He's like, yeah, whatever, you know, we could both do it any time. We just didn't because we respect you. Finally, the freaky gunfingers guy, I think his name is Franklin, speaks up and he's like, guys, remember, you know, the spider has to survive. All in all, the spider has to survive. You know, if the boss doesn't return, then, eh, we'll get a new boss. That's how the spider works. So then the Phantom Troop kind of just agrees and they allow Pakunoda to leave with Gon and Killua. But oh no, Hisoka is following. That dick. He calls up Kurapika and he's like, hey, what's up? He just really wants to fight the boss. So allow that to happen and he'll leave the airship and he won't be an issue. He promises he won't do anything bad aside. He just wants to fight the boss. So they meet after they ride some airships and they make the exchange. Krolla goes one way, Gon and Killua go the other way. So now Pakunoda leaves and Hisoka and Krolla are gonna fight now, I guess. That makes sense. What? And so Hisoka reveals that he was never part of the Phantom Troop in the first place. You know, it was just a fake tattoo. And he's like, yes, yes, now we can fight for realsies. Oh, okay, so the judgment, the chain that Kurapika used on Krolla prevents him from ever using Nen. So he's like, there's really no point in us fighting. It would be like, it wouldn't be fun for you. And Hisoka's like, all my dreams. So he just decides, yeah, I'm done with this. He doesn't want to fight anymore. I didn't realize that Kurapika used his chains to make it so that Krolla couldn't use Nen anymore. That's actually really, really funny. So everyone's back together. Our group of four is like happy, and I guess this is how they're gonna go back to Greed Island. I wish there had been a big fight. I'm a little disappointed, but I guess it was pretty awesome the way it worked out. Okay, so Pakunoda goes back to the Phantom Troop and she has a gun. And her plan is to shoot people with a gun. And so she shoots them all with her memories, all the founding members. And then she dies because she's not allowed to use Nen. All right, I get it. So that kills her. I get it. Okay, all right. I get it! So she wasn't allowed to talk because of Kurapika's. Okay, all right, no, stop, I get it. And then Gon tells Killua his secret plan of getting Greed Island, and Killua's like, oh, that's a great idea, actually. I didn't realize that it was so foolproof. So then they go to the auction house. This is kind of insane right now. And the Phantom Troop is there. Awkward. So it's Finks and Phaeton, and they're like, hey, bros, we're not gonna kill you, but we'd like some info. We've noticed that the boss can no longer use Nen. So we know that we can't kill the chain user, because if we kill a chain user, then that might end up killing the boss. And the boss is off searching for someone who can remove the chain that's preventing him from using Nen. And Finks, the tracksuit guy, he got some of Pakunoda's memories, so he remembers this interaction she had with them, where they didn't run away from her because they wanted the exchange to happen so that Kurapika wouldn't have to kill anyone. And so he says, like, Pakunoda wanted to thank you for that interaction that she had with you. And that's the end of the Ocean City arc. Okay, so obviously next up we have the Greed Island arc. You've all waded into my schedule, and I've developed a Greed Island arc schedule that I think makes everyone happy. And my upcoming hiatus, I'm pretty much taking a break from all shows for like a month. But once I come back from the hiatus in September, I'll be starting the Chimera Ant arc. And in the description of this video is my proposed schedule for the Chimera Ant arc, just based on numbers, that's all, literally nothing else. So please let me know if I'm doing it wrong. I'll see you next time for the Greed Island arc review, basically. Bye!